Howdy folks, and welcome to World of Tanks with the Mighty Jingles, and it's TOG Platoon time! Me, Quickie Baby, and Ike. Three-man TOG Platoon, because the TOG is a party tank. Single TOGs are lonely TOGs. We're here on Highway. It's the new Highway map. All sorts of cover. Well, I say it's a new map, it's been around for a while now. It's no longer quite as ridiculously one-sided. Now that the team that start from the south, just speed things up here because I am in a TOG, it is going to take a while to get anywhere. Yeah, the team that starts from the south isn't so ridiculously handicapped anymore. I do like this map now. Three-man TOG platoons are great. Or they are if you do them properly. You see, you have to think of a TOG platoon not as three individual tanks, but as one mega tank, built from the parts of lesser tanks. If you think of it as one tank that fires 36 rounds per minute and has 4,200 health, you're doing it right. And the TOG naturally preys on tanks like T-150s and KV-1Ss. And the reason it works is that, well, you just take advantage of the stupidity of your enemies. The TOG is not about the alpha damage, right? Nobody ever rolled around a corner, got shot by a TOG and thought, whoa, what the hell was that? On the other hand, getting shot at by a KV-1S or a T-150 with the alpha damage from their 122 and 107mm guns tends to give people a bit of a pause for thought. But time after time after time, and you're going to see it in this replay, KV-1S drivers just doing it wrong. If you get a chance to shoot at a TOG in a KV-1S, by all means do it. You've got one of the best guns available at the kind of matchmaking that the TOG gets into to whittle that TOG's monstrous 1400 health down. But when you're reloading, don't sit in front of him. Especially don't sit in front of three of them. You're going to get hit 36 times a minute. Well, you're not, because you'll be dead long before that happens. Watch this. So we finally arrived. Enemy tanks have made it into the town, and there's our first victim, KV-1S. Now, to be fair, this guy can't actually see us. We can only see him because of the KV-1Ss up in front that are spotting him. But he's getting shot over and over. Quickie Baby can't hit him, Quickie Baby's on the higher ground. Me and I can just reduce him to a one-shot kill, and then bounce. And Ike bounces. And I penetrate and do no damage. And Ike misses. And then I bounce. And then Ike misses. And finally I kill him. RNG at its finest. But isn't that always the way? As soon as you've got a tank down to a one-shot kill, your next 15 shots do nothing to him. And there's another one there. Oh, it's M6. Okay, I like the look of that M6. You'll notice we have not been spotted yet. These guys are too far away. We're going to get spotted now, though. Here comes another KV-1S. Watch this guy. Well, at least he's smart. Okay, that one bounced. At least he's smart enough to turn his front to us. And he doesn't know which one of us to... he's going to shoot at me. And my tracks eat it. And once again, he's a one-shot kill. And zero damage. But I really shouldn't start complaining about this because my first shot got eaten by his tracks. And yes, I did just bounce a shot from a KV-1S in the TOG. If you're driving a KV-1S and this happens, you have to sell the tank. Okay? When you get out of the game, you go back to the garage, you sell the tank, and you never play it again. Those are the rules. I don't make the rules. I just work here. Oh, and there's another one. We're going to have him too. Yeah. Hey. Oh. Okay. Two of them shooting at me now, and I'm in trouble. I don't have a lot of health. I killed the jumbo. And come on, die. Oh, thank you, Quickie Baby. Okay, I've had enough of being brave now. I don't want to get shot anymore. Maybe take some pot shots at this... what is it? A43. Yeah, there we go. Did a bit of damage. I'm happy with that. I really don't want to die now. I think while this game was going on, there was a special. 75,000 credits for finishing in the top three and not dying. So I really don't want to die now. Of course, I do want to do some more damage. Quickie Baby had a monster game in his TOG in this match. You'll see at the end on the battle results, he was actually over there to the right, just on that little bit of high ground, up off to the side of the railway embankment. From up there he was shooting at them not only as they were moving into the town, but also once they got into the town. And this is pretty much it for me in this match. I never get to fire the gun again. Everything else, well, the SU-152 is going to die before I can bring the gun to bear on him. And the remaining enemy tanks are much too far away for me to have any further input in the rest of this game. That, unfortunately, is the way of the TOG. Also, I thought, there's still a Chiteau and a T-43 in play. And they were last spotted bloody miles away. Now, the SU-152 did spot me, and I don't really want to get hit anymore. So I'm just hiding up in the... Oh, hello. There goes the T-43. Now, I don't actually have a direct line of fire to him, because he's down in the low ground. But he still has a lot of health. So maybe, just maybe... Oh, the Cheeto's just been spotted as well. He's there on the map. If I'd reacted a little faster, I might have been able to steal that kill. But nope. The T-43, on the other hand, M6 is fighting him off. That one missed. Come on. Hey! TOG wins. Totally worth sticking around. And it turns out there wasn't actually a credit bonus for finishing in the top three and surviving the match. So I must have been thinking of some other event. But, I've just been passed a message from the TOG. He wants me to read it out. It says, "Dear KV-1S and T-150 drivers, next time you come round corner and see a TOG, please sit still and reload in the open. This makes TOG happy in his pants. Hugs and kisses, the TOG." Now, this is a tank that you do not see very often these days. This is the Micro Mouse, the Panzer 38H735F. This is a French tank that was captured by the Wehrmacht in large numbers at the start of the Second World War, from the French. It was never a very common tank, even when it was ridiculously overpowered. Kind of like the Panzer IIJ, this is one of these tiny little German light tanks. It's only tier 2 that is very, very hard to kill. It's got very, very good armor. This is why they used to call it the Micro Mouse. Its armor isn't as overpowered as the Panzer IIJ, and the gun is not very good, but it's slightly better than the Panzer IIJs. You certainly don't need to use premium ammo in this thing the way you really do in the Panzer IIJ, but the gun's not that good. If you have a look here, there we go, 41mm of penetration and 40 damage. But it's rapid firing and it's not too inaccurate. The days when this tank was ridiculously overpowered are long gone. I want to use the word suffers from power creep. It doesn't suffer from power creep, it's been balanced by power creep. There are all kinds of machines that can deal with the armour on this tank these days. Machines like that T-82. The Marder 2 has always been able to beat the armour on this thing. Things like the Cruiser 4, some of those low-tier French tank destroyers. There are a lot more machines around that are a threat to this tank now than they were when I used to play this thing. I haven't played this thing in a long time. I did at one point. I can clearly remember. Myself and a friend both had one of them years ago. You don't really have to worry about getting shot at by a Panzer 1C, although he did knock out my commander. More on that in a moment. But yeah, I can clearly remember playing this thing a while back with a friend who said, you know what, we'd been playing for hours one night, and he said, tell you what, let's just both jump into the Micro Mouse and we'll keep playing until we lose a game. 2 hours later, I ended up throwing a match just so I could go to bed. As you can see, front of the Panzer 1C, I might have hit that slow part of his upper glacis, but it didn't penetrate, and I'm not penetrating his side. The gun is adequate. It's certainly better than the Panzer II J's gun, but it's not very good. T2 medium over there. He landed a nasty hit on me. Oh, actually, it was an SU-76. Hit me for 94. I'm down to 58 health. It only has 160 in the first place. Look at the Panzer I C driver. Yay, I'm killed by Jingles. Now, regarding the crew, this thing only has two crew. A commander and a driver. And the commander is also the loader, and he's also the gunner. So losing the commander in this thing is a major blow. Let's have a quick look. Actually, I can't show you it yet because I'm in the bush, but at the front of this tank there is a driver's hatch. If you fire a shot... Oh, there's a T-46. Fire a shot through that driver's hatch, you'll kill the driver. You hit the turret anywhere, you'll kill the commander. At that point, you've knocked the tank out. It doesn't matter how much health it has remaining. I've seen so many of these tanks on full health, or with at least some health left, but the tank's dead because the crew have all been knocked out. I really shouldn't be giving the secrets away. Now, I keep firing at this Panzer I C. Watch this. I'm firing at his last known position. Nothing. Right. He's still driving around somewhere. Also, I thought. I thought he'd moved. Ike is about to pop up next to me. Bang, there he goes. He's just killed him. The guy hadn't moved at all. If I'd fired one more shot, I would have probably killed him. Oh, well. Now, at this point in the battle, Quickie Baby is there in his Panzer 38H, and he's spotted. I was very slow to notice this, but to be fair to me, I did have plenty of other things to shoot at. He's realised that we've lost the hill, and they're going to be coming around. And we do need to get back over there. So I turn around, but I don't want to just drive straight there. Yeah, there we go. Cruiser 4. Quickie Baby left him on one health, but Quickie Baby's dead. Myself and Ike are going to have to go back. I don't want to just drive straight back there, though, because I only have 58 health left. There's a Cruiser 4. If he's got that 40mm gun, he can give me problems. There's also an M3 Light over there, and he has a nasty gun. More importantly, I can't penetrate those guys from this range. In fact, I struggle to penetrate the front of an M3 Light from any range. This gun is that, you know, mediocre. Plus, we've got an AFK-er and a Panzer I C, so we can at least be using him to spot these guys if they try to come over the railway line. But a Marder going back. He's not going to be able to hit an awful lot from down there. He's moving forward now. Ike's moving along the railway line. Now, poor situational awareness here. I did not realise that Ike was on the other side of the tracks. I don't know why he moved over that side, because he's cut himself off from all supporting fire. Now, I suspect he didn't realise that there were quite as many of them there as there are. There's actually three of them. He was probably driving down there thinking, oh, a one-shot kill against the Cruiser 4. No problem. Yeah, but the Cruiser 4 has two friends with him. Now, Ike doesn't really have to worry about the Panzer 1C, but the M3 Light and the Cruiser 4 can hurt him. And worryingly, he hasn't spotted them. Oh, there we go. He's detected them now. Come on, Ike, kill the Cruiser 4. They're hurting him. He's got the Cruiser 4. He's done some more damage to the Panzer 1C. And then they finish him off. Okay. Technically, there's four of us left, but realistically, there's only three of us. Panzer 1C behind me is AFK. So I need to try to get under their guns. I'm expecting the M3 to pop up over there. He did it before, he's probably going to try and do it again. Unfortunately, okay, I did get penned by the Panzer 1C. And There goes the X3 light. Yeah, knew that was coming. How do I deal with this guy first? Blow his traps off. Come on, then the Marder gets him. Good. Down 48 health. M3 light is trying the same thing again. Now he's giving me his side. Yes. Ah, he penned me. I'm on 5 health. Angle the tank. Angle the tank. Bounce the shot. He's giving me his side. Gotta try and finish him off. Don't let him turn that frontal armour. Got him. Whew. Now, what's left? The M2 medium. 75mm howitzer. High explosive shells. I only have 5 health. A Marder and an SU-76. Panzer 1C's taken some damage, but as long as he's still alive, I can still... Crap. SU-76. And the M2 medium. If that shot hadn't bounced, and if that shot hadn't bounced, this game could have had a very, very different outcome. Possibly. Panzer 38T. They've killed the Panzer 1C. Fine. He was AFK anyway. But the Panzer 38 has spotted the Marder. I have not been detected. The SU-76 hasn't actually seen me yet. They've killed the Panzer 38. I'm alone. Finish off the Marder before he disappears? Yes. This is where I screw it up. I'll pause it here. There's the SU-76. He's a two-shot kill for me. But look where I am. I'm so close to the bushes that I can see through them. Now, if I'd been thinking straight and not feeling the pressure of being the last one left alive, what I should have done here is pull back from the bushes so that I could no longer see through them. I would still be able to spot the SU-76 for a couple of seconds after cutting myself off from line of sight, but he would not detect me shooting at him, which would have meant that I could kill this guy and still remain undetected against the M2 medium. Instead, I make a stupid mistake, and I get the kill on the SU-76, but the M2 medium now knows where I am, and all he has to do is hit me once with his 75mm high explosive howitzer. So, stupid error at the end costs us the game, and yet, wait until you see the result. Yep, if I'd managed to win that, if I hadn't choked at the end and screwed it up, that would have been over 3,000 experience. Doubled, first win of the day, in a tier 2 tank. but thanks to Confederate, high caliber and cool-headed, I got the Courageous Resistance Award at least. And so I did get, you know, an adequate amount of XP and credits out of it, but 1114 damage done in a tier 2 tank. The gun only does 40 damage per hit. That wasn't a bad game. And I didn't mind losing it that much. I deserved to lose it. I screwed up. The enemy team were better than our team. They deserved to win. It would have been nice to win, but credit where credit's due. The enemy team played well. They were better than we were. Final match, I'm in the IS-7. I'm platooned with, again, Quickie Baby and Ike. Ike doesn't have an IS-7. Quickie Baby's in his. Anytime we're in a tier 10 heavy tank, Ike just rolls out the T110 E5. That's all he's got. I think the heaviest Russian tank he has is the STI. And he doesn't even have that fully upgraded. He's, you know, he's working on it, but I just rolls out the T110 E5. Same at Tier 9. Tier 9 heavies, M103. You know, me and Quickie Baby are changing tanks every match. Same tanks every time. T110 E5, M103. But it's a decent tank to have backing you up in an IS-7. The two tanks couldn't be any different. The IS-7 it's a heavy assault tank. The armour is pretty good, especially in the front, and the turret is amazing. It's got this monster 130mm naval gun. It's quick as well. The engine power is a little lacking, but the top speed is great. When you get this thing moving, it is fast. We're here on steps. It's a random battle. Quickie Baby and myself both in the IS-7. I've got some support here. from this ISA. Quickie Baby's going over the top. I'm cutting around the flank. Between us, we're going to start carving up these tanks. Now, we need to watch out here because the enemy Jagdpanzer E100, let me just quickly give this AMX 5120 driver the fright of his life and then bounce a shot from him. But yes, the enemy Jagdpanzer E100, the mighty Jaegeru, he's a very good player. The enemy artillery is a very good player. The Waffenträger 4 is a very good player. And we're going to see all of them down this side of the map. Jagdtiger, Ike kills him, which allows me to pop up and take another shot at the AMX 5120 before he dies. I'm now going to use this Jagdtiger as cover and take a parting shot at the ass of this Batchat. He knows he's not going to get away. There we go. The Jagdtiger driver appears to have been somewhat upset that Ike killed him. I love it when they get mad in chat. Now, from this point on, Quickie Baby's life becomes a misery. Enemy artillery started focusing on him exclusively. And he doesn't have a very good game of it. There's the Jaegeru. He's just pulled out a cover, and I'm looking at this ISA, and I'm just willing him to not do this because I can see what's coming. And there it is. But the Jaegeru has fired, which means, nope, don't get a shot at him. Can I? Nope, I'm not going to get a shot at him either. Back off, conscious of the fact that artillery is good. And you know what artillery's like with me. Now the Waffenträger, there he is, the Waffenträger 4. He's a one shot for Ike. If Ike can kill this guy, that leaves us clear to sneak around the side and approach the Jaegeru undetected. Ike's got him, good. E-75, Jaegeru does not have line of fire to me. E-75 in the open. Ike plants one into him. That one, I don't know. Did it hit? Couldn't say. He disappeared. I fired it where he was. It was a side shot. But, you know, he was kind of slightly angled and might have gone into his tracks. Don't know. Anyway, he's gone. Jaegeru does still not have a line of fire at me. So with Ike, we push up. We advance. Quickie Baby's taken some big old artillery hits there. And the enemy T110E3... pulls off an amazing shot. I'm spotted again. It's the E-75. Although he's not looking this way. Get another shot into him. And then he manages to get into cover. And there. Enemy T-110E3 is on the other side of the map. And he managed to hit Quickie Baby's IS-7 and take him out. That was a hell of a shot. But Quickie Baby's game is over. Now is this E-75 going to give me a shot? Wait for it. Wait for the side of the tank. That'll do. Spotted. Artillery's still there. The Jaegeru's dead. Fantastic news. We can go around this corner now. And that's it. Now pretty much everybody on this side of the map is done. Tanks like the Waffenträger 4, the Jagdpanzer E100 can do a lot of damage to your team. But they need a screen in front of them of other tanks to spot and take hits for them. Wipe out the screen with this aggressive push around the south and they're gonna get another shot off maybe, but they cannot stand against a push from this many tanks at once. ISA rams the artillery. And have a look at the map up to the north in front of us. Our T110E3 is fighting off every remaining tier 10 heavy tank on the enemy team and the tortoise with support from our artillery, and he's fighting them to a standstill. This guy was an absolute rock star. He's protecting the artillery and he's holding off all the remaining enemy tanks. He can't do it forever. They're going to kill him. But it took four tier 10 heavies and a tier 9 tank destroyer to put this guy down. What a boss. This was just a good team. The enemy team had some good players, but they were let down by the donkeys on their team, which is always the way of it. You know, that's just the way World of Tanks works. Yeah, he can see me, but I'm not worried. At that angle, he would only be able to hit my turret, and the front of the turret of the IS-7 just doesn't get penetrated. Now, can I just do some more damage before the game's over? because that's pretty much what this is all about at this point. There's no way we're losing this. But we've literally driven a circle around the entire map, and now we're back where we started. And aim for the cheek, got the IS-7. Can I reload in time to get one more shot at the IS-4? Probably not. And nope. Rest of the team says, not this time, Jingles. That one, of course, was all about the team. The team made me look good in that game. You know, I'd like to sit here and I did do the most damage, but I had to struggle to do the damage that I did. Constantly, well, doing what the IS-7 is supposed to do. Advancing, attacking, pushing, punishing the enemy defences. That's what it was for. It's very good at it. Thankfully, the team was good enough that I could actually play the tank in that style in that game. Always either on the move or shooting. Never sitting around a corner, camping a corner or a bush, and just waiting for somebody to lumber out in front of your gun. Thanks to the quality of the teamwork and the aggression displayed by the team in that random battle, we were actually able to put the IS-7 to the purpose for which it was intended. That's it for today, folks. Three tanks couldn't have been more different if they tried. The IS-7, the Mighty Tog 2, and the Micro Mouse. Hope you enjoyed the video. As always, take care on that battlefield, and I'll catch you next time.